Remember like 10,000 years ago when you had to type in a code or draw a pattern to unlock your smartphone? Actually, you probably don't because most people didn't bother using the lock feature on their phones. And that was a problem, since any old person could just pick up your phone and pretend to be you. They could send themselves money with your banking app, they could impersonate you on social media, they could leave positive reviews of really terrible movies. Just awful stuff. This was the problem that biometrics were supposed to solve. Instead of having to take a frustrating 2 seconds to enter a code, you could just smash your dumb digit against a fingerprint reader and, hey presto, phone opened. And it was a great solution. And then we all collectively decided that facial recognition was the next logical move. Instead of touching a sensor with your dumb finger, you could just hold up your phone to your dumb face and it magically unlocks. And this was the worst decision in the history of consumer technology. Fight me. Like removing the headphone jack and the move to facial recognition, the simple, serviceable, and secure solution was replaced with one that is worse in every respect. And what did we get out of it? Phones that are twice as expensive with slightly larger screens. So what's wrong with facial recognition? For one thing, it doesn't do a good job of keeping people out of your phone, which is its job. There are numerous reports from the Pixel 4 and other devices that people were able to unlock their phones with their eyes closed. That meant that when you're asleep, unconscious, or dead, someone could just walk up and unlock your phone. And it gets worse! Facial recognition cannot, for example, tell the difference between identical twins. That might be an isolated problem, but if we've learned anything from Star Trek, it's that there's an entire universe filled with crappy versions of ourselves that could definitely unlock your phone. Even worse, facial recognition is just not a useful way of determining intent. So think about it this way. You only type in your password when you intend to use it. You don't just shout it out at random or type it in the middle of your script, Shrek 424 ever. If you can accidentally open your phone just by looking at it, that's not a good system. With a fingerprint reader, you have to place your finger on a sensor, which is much harder to do by accident than simply looking at something. This becomes a real problem when you start thinking about being compelled to open your phone by someone in authority. You really should not take legal advice from me, please don't do that. But it's my understanding that law enforcement is on firmer legal footing compelling you to submit biometrics than they are forcing you to say your password. That's why we've seen a lockdown mode become available on some devices. This temporarily blocks the use of biometrics and requires a code to unlock your phone. It's to prevent security people at the airport from opening your phone by holding it up to your face.
But wait, Max, you love security. Don't you want facial recognition everywhere?
Don't be a cop. But the biggest problem with facial recognition isn't what we're doing with our phones. That's actually pretty good and pretty secure. What's bad and dumb and should go away immediately is that we're getting too comfortable with this technology and it's starting to show up everywhere. But also, as much as I love security, I really love privacy. And facial recognition on a large scale is the total absence of privacy. Consider, if you will, a crowded room of strangers, and you are looking for one person. If you only know that person's name, then you probably won't be able to find them. If you have that person's fingerprint, you will find them eventually, but not before everyone else figures out that you're looking for someone. If you have a picture of the person and a sophisticated facial recognition algorithm, you can quickly tell if the person is in the room without anyone knowing. If you watch long enough, you'll see them come and go, you see who they talk to and who those people talk to and so on and so forth. It's tons of information that you wouldn't have otherwise. And now imagine that instead of you, the viewer, monitoring this imaginary room, it's your friendly faceless government agency. That probably sounds scary. Probably doesn't sound like a room you'd want to spend a lot of time in. But we've already seen American cities begin to roll out facial recognition for law enforcement. China has pioneered its use as well, and just recently in the UK, which is home of the most surveillance cameras on the planet, they've recently started using facial recognition technology. Amazon is also getting on the act with super cheap face matching system for law enforcement. They are also the people behind the Ring camera, which also has a kind of creepy closey relationship with local police. Most people are probably not too keen on the idea of their face being ID'd and tracked everywhere they go. But I worry that it seems less scary if people keep scanning their own faces with their phones 7 or 8 times an hour. Maybe they'll get used to it. Maybe they'll start to think it's a good idea. Maybe they'll start to like it. 2 things I need you to do to save yourself and to save the world. Number 1, vote for politicians that value your privacy and mine more than they do juicy contracts from security companies. Number 2, turn off face scanning on your phone, and better yet, smash your phone and go buy one that has at most a fingerprint reader. Because you deserve a security model that actually works and that your mirror universe double can't open.